Good morning, everyone. This is a quick video on how to establish a VPN IPsec tunnel between two CompSet CM685VW. Okay, let's log into the first router. The IP address is 192.168.1.1. Username and password in lowercase, admin admin. Okay, now here we have the status page. As you can see, the cell status is up and we have an IP address. However, it is a private IP address. To be able to establish a VPN IPsec tunnel, we need to have a public IP address. Now the SIM card that I have is a Telstra SIM card, which is enabled for public IP. All I need to do is change the APN. So I go to network, to the left hand side, select mobile, and then instead of having telstra.internet, I need to have telstra.extranet. And this will give me a public IP address. Click on save and apply. But of course, first you need to enable it with your carrier, or Telstra in this case. Now this public IP address is dynamic. It is not static. If it was static, we will go ahead and start the VPN configuration. But because it is dynamic, I need to configure dynamic DNS or DIN DNS. Go to services, select DDNS. And here we have two examples, IPv4 and IPv6. So just edit the IPv4 example, enable. Here you can select from the service providers. There's drop-down menu. I'm using dindns.org, and you type in the host name, compset02. dot dvrdns.org. This is for the first router or the local router. The username, and the password. And click save and apply. Okay, so as you can see here, we have the host name, compset02dvrdns.org, which is linked to this public IP address, and it is enabled. Just click on start. Okay, now we need to do the same for the remote router, which I have already done. So I just open a new tab, and the remote router has a host name, which is compset2016. dot dvrdns.org. Okay, so the username and password is the same, admin admin, and this is the status page overview. As you can see, we have the cell status is up and we have a public IP address linked to the host name which we just entered. Okay, so now we can go ahead and configure the VPN IPsec between the remote router and the local router. I'll start with the local router, which is the tab to the left hand side. So we go to services again and select VPN. Here we have IPsec, PPTP, L2TP, OpenVPN, and GRE. So in this case, we're doing the IPsec, just enable it. And the authentication method is, this is a client because it's a local router. The remote VPN endpoint, select custom, and it is, as we said, compset2016.dvrdns.org. the local is compset02. Of course, when we configure the remote route, it'll be the other way around. Now, the pre-shared keys, you can select any length between 6 and 32. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Just make sure it's the same pre-shared key on the remote router as well. Keep the rest as it is. Scroll down. Here we have the local subnet is 192.168.1.0, which is correct. The remote subnet is 192.168, which I have configured earlier. It's .100.0. So I'll change that to 100. And here we have phase one proposal and phase two proposal. I'm going to keep the default settings, but if you do make any changes, make sure you change it on the remote router as well. Click on save and apply. And that's it. This is done for the local router. Now, the remote router, I have already configured exactly the same thing, but just to show you, I'll go to the remote router. Let's go to the LAN just to show you. If you go to network, LAN, and as you can see, it's 192.168.100.1. That's why I changed it on the local router. Now, if you go to VPN services, VPN, and here we have the remote DIN DNS host name and the local, so it's the other way around here. And the pre-shared key is exactly the same, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. And we kept, here we have, of course, the local subnet is .100 and the remote is .1. Yeah. Okay, so I'm not gonna save anything here because I haven't made any changes. All we need to do is go to status, VPN, and here, as you can see, we have a tunnel being established. Let's go to the local router as well, go to status and VPN, and as you can see, there's one tunnel up between 192.168.1.0 and 192.168.100.0. Thank you for watching.